So I just encourage all you young men to be steadfast and unmovable.
Always abiding.
Let them all be in it.
But hold on. You're going to be all right. You're going to be all right. You got to go through. And the same thing with you young ladies. You got to go through. Amen. There's no need for us being so hard on these children. Because they got to go through. We went through it.
That's right.
Some of us slid through on the prayer of our mothers and fathers.
That's right.
Amen. But when you get to the other side, and I'm not talking about over in glory, I'm talking about on this side of joy, you're going to find out that it's a lot of joy in Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The things that we look at now from the natural eye, it won't matter no more.
That's right.
Because the spiritual eye, you will fall in love.
Yes, you will.
So I just want y'all, as the Lord direct my mind, to be encouraged. Be encouraged. No, Rick, can you song like you never sung before?
Yes, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Y'all can be seated. Lord, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to ask the Lord, what would he have you to do? And make up your mind to come here. What he tell you to do? You got some greater story. You didn't go through all what you went through. But that is not in vain. So God got his hands on
you. Amen. Amen.
Y'all, excuse me. I just feel like all these songs have been sung today, they've been timely. Amen. That's why we believe in you. And let the Holy Spirit have his way in this place. Because he knows what we need. It's not about how good it sounds or what it looks like. He said, I am the way. The truth and the life. I give honor to my Heavenly Father, who loves us so dear. We love him, who cares for us, and we care for him, to be very fine preachers that God has anointed and appointed himself. Reverend Cooper, Evangelist Dr. Smith, Minister Wright, Minister Morgan. Amen. Thank God. Most of all, we thank God for you all that sit in the pew. I just want you all to know, in God's eyesight, you all are just as important as we are sitting on this pulpit. Because you have the title of a preacher, don't make you no special than nobody else. just been our calling.
That's
all that is. It's the calling. Because the ones, some of y'all are sitting in the pew, are very anointed. Might not get anointed to stand behind and say, yes, but you got your anointing on you. Because that's what makes the church work. And that's why it's so important for us to find out what our purpose is. Line up with the purpose. And then the anointing kicks in. And that's what makes everything all right. Amen. That's fresh from the email off the from heaven. Amen. I just like to encourage you because, you know, so many people are down. So many people just think that their life feel like nothing. But you are precious in God's sight. Don't let no human being tell you you're nothing. You are somebody. You are precious in the sight of God. Amen. And that's enough for me now. Amen. As long as I'm precious in His sight. Because one of these days, see, I'm going to leave Jackie. But I want to be pleased with Him. Because that's where I'm going to stay.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I know when she gets to glory, she sure ain't going to look for me.
I'm looking for Jesus.
Well, I can tell you why. It's not because I'm a bad husband with Gary. It's because she's looking for the one that made her and saved her. She said, I don't have no heaven or hell to put in. Amen. And I really want her to look for me. Because when I get there, I'm not looking for her, my mother, my father. I'm looking for King Jesus. That's what I'm looking for. And I'm not going to tell her about my struggle, not my trouble. But when I get there, I just want to say, amen. Thank you, Jesus. For all that I went through, you brought me through. Oh, I tell you, we're serving the church. The world can't do anything. Let me get out of my message. But the world can't do anything for you. They give you a bunch of money, but your soul. The Lord took me somewhere this week, sweetheart. And I could relate to Moses. When he took Moses up on top of Mount Nebo, when he looked over, said, now you look at the promised land, but you won't get there. And I could just hear people crying one day, saying, Lord, have mercy. If I had a mansion, I said, Lord, Lord. And you know, I was sitting on my porch, and I couldn't help from crying. Lord have mercy. But then he showed me the streets, never was shining streets. I said, my God. I said, Lord, that's why I'm trying to get through. Even with pain wrecking my body, even sometimes confused, but I won't give up. Don't have money in my pocket. But you said you'll never leave me.
Hallelujah.
If I gotta go through it, I'm willing to go through it. Because one moment in this kingdom is gonna be worth it all. I bless his name. I don't know about you, but I bless his name. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. That's a closer walk with me. That's all I want. That's a little closer walk with me. Oh, Oh, great Jehovah.
That's all right.
See, that's why the church is being persecuted. See, he knew that he was going to get the church. Because he won't start at my household of faith. So he can cut us down from praying. The world really would go to hell in a handbasket. But the pride of the righteous, of God, some of us sit around right now. The only reason we're here because of prayer. Stop saying I wish I had and say it's gonna come. I want you to start praying and say, that's mine. Stop talking about I want this, I wish I had it. Stop claiming. The children just told us, we are walking in authority. You got to use your authority. We shouldn't be lacking nothing. We the children of the Most High. But when God blesses you, the Holy Ghost. But when He blesses you, you got to bless somebody else. Don't ask God to give you SC Mercedes did, and you just go ride around and profile it. But you got to get out your bed at night when somebody call you and take that SC350. Go pick them up. Take them to the river. That's how you get blessed. And then I'm going to tell you something, get to my message. That's why so many of us have holes in our pocket. We don't help nobody unless you're in my clique. If you will help and listen to the Spirit. Rick, if you don't have a $5, if the Spirit of God said, give that $5 up, give it up. Because when you get home, you're going to have $505. Let me get to the message. I'm gonna tell them. I'm gonna let y'all go home. Because he's not going to buy you a house. He said, said, if you abide in me, you can ask what you will. Tell your witness, you can call LeBron up and tell him I need a house. He wanna hang up on you. But Jesus never. But I'm telling you about somebody. Even the Andrew Johnson.
Come on,
Yeah. You know what? The Bible says, seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all the other things. I wish I could turn it to loose. But let me tell you, young men and young women, you don't have to push no drugs. You don't have to sell your body. Only thing you got to do is be committed unto Jesus. Not only will he send you a fine man, he'll give you a fine home, fine children. Everything I thought I had together this morning, I messed around and left it at home. We had the wrong Bible. Would anybody believe that's the wrong Bible?
No.
Let I'm just saying what you missed.
How you gonna have the wrong Bible?
I just got the Bible that I don't even preach out of. But there's no wrong word.
Amen.
Let's get in there. So I can stay right there and get a benediction.
Let the Lord use you, Pastor. Let the Lord use you, Pastor. Yeah!
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Keep on, it's all right. So, he said, I will give you the desire of your heart. Oh, listen to me. And I'm going to start at that 9th verse. That's
to the Lord. Amen. Amen. The chapter of Revelation began the 9th verse. I'm going to read down to the 11th. Amen. Once you get to say amen. And the word of God here in the book of Revelation. Here John began to write under the inspiration of the Holy Ghost. I, John, am your brother and your partner in suffering in God's kingdom and in the patient endurance to which Jesus called us.
Yes, Lord.
I was exiled to the Isle of Patmos for preaching the word of God and for my testimony about Jesus.
Yeah.
It was the Lord's day and I was worshiping in the spirit. Suddenly, I heard behind me a loud voice like a trumpet blast. It said, write in a book everything you see and send it to the seven churches in the city of Ephesus, Samaria, Pergamon, Thyatira, Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea. I'm going to stop right there. But it's much more to come. With the permission of the Holy Spirit, I want to talk from this subject, a man that God can trust and a church that will listen. A man that God can trust and a church that will listen. Here, you see in the book of Revelation here, John, was under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. But if you go back and look at John's history, John was with Jesus in the beginning. And he had walked with him through the miracles that God had did. But if you look at the Gospel of John, John wrote more distinctly about the life of Jesus. It wasn't so much about his birth, but about his resurrection and his death, burial, and resurrection. He was more distinct than Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. I got quiet on me. That's good.
Come on, come on.
Then if you look, he began to write 1 John, 2 John, and 3 John. And those books, he looked like he switched and began talking about love. Because when you've been with somebody and you know somebody, then you can love. See, we don't got this thing messed up because we done met Joe Blow 3 months ago. I've been with him a year. That we is love. No. There ain't no love. Might be a little infatuation, but there ain't no love. You don't even know. Matter of fact, you probably don't know his middle name yet. Can I get a witness here? Sometimes you can be with them 10 or 15 years and still don't know them. Because one day Jekyll and Mr. Hyde might come out. And you say, who is this? But look at John. Most of the time when I'm reading and listening, my mind always reflect on Peter. Which Peter was a good man. But something about John, that John was a quiet man. He walked with Jesus. He was at the Mount of Transfiguration. But the thing about it is, he wasn't a person like Peter. He had that different personality, but the same love. But look at here. Now, here in John I mean, in the book of Revelation. One day, John here wouldn't stop preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. And the Romans got him and carried him to Patmos. This might not be a shoutness, but y'all ought to get in the book of Revelation. And the Bible said that over there in Patmos, it was a little rocky place. It was about 50 miles off of the shore of Ephesus. But see, even at that time, be put it in an isolated place.
That's right.
But what I'm trying to tell you, don't get upset when people don't want to listen to you. They might kick you to the curb. That might be your isolated place. That God can use you. Y'all gonna catch it when you get home.
Come on.
Because it was there at Alapatlas, 50 miles off the shore, when God came and began to use him. Began to use him and through the Holy Spirit and showed John vision. Even the church was facing persecution. I can tell you, we are facing persecution.
Yeah.
They talk about have already taken prayer out of school.
Yeah.
And you know, you got to be careful, because even in the house, people really don't want you to preach the gospel.
That's right.
They don't mind if you tell them it's all right to have a house faith. But the Bible didn't say that. No. We gonna preach what the word says. Can I get a witness there?
That's right.
That they were facing persecution. Believers, and said almost all the believers were socially, political, economically suffering.
Yeah.
Do y'all see that happening now?
Yeah.
Suffering because they really don't know and trust God. How can you love somebody that you don't know about? Come on, man. Stop swinging for me. Help me out. We got to start spending time in the Word, lay prostrate before Him. Can I get a witness now? You can't just pick up your Bible on Sunday morning, walk out to a church. I don't care what church you go to. And think that you're ready to face the world. You got to spend time before the Lord. But the Bible said here, John exiled the pastor because he refused to stop preaching the good news. But I stopped by to tell you, but it was on the Lord's day. He said, I was worshiping in the spirit.
Yes,
my God, have you ever been home at your desk or somewhere in your car and you began to just pray and praise God?
Yes,
and after a while, you began to feel the spirit moving.
Yes,
I believe that John was out there by himself.
Yes,
but really, he wasn't by himself, because God was right there with him. But John said, suddenly, I heard behind me a loud voice like a trumpet. My God, yes, you got to have an ear to hear to what the Spirit is saying to the church. But I stopped by to tell you, they're not talking to St. Jude, but it's talking to this church. Can I get a witness here? Because the church is in us. This is a place we just come and worship. Can I get a witness here? But I looked at the text and I saw a man that God can trust. But only if the church will listen. Can I get a witness here? But the Bible said if we hesitate to share our faith during easy times, like how will we do during time of persecution? Can I get a witness here? Because if we don't have faith now, what you gonna do when trials come? When persecution comes, you sure gonna run and hide. Can I get a witness here? You gonna run to the rock that you can't hide. Can I get a witness here? Yes, we got to use our faith. Can I get a witness here? Use it, Ricky. Stretch out on your faith. Lord, have mercy. I wish I had some help here. But the Bible said, told John, said, look at his son. I want you to write in a book everything you see. And then send it to the seven churches. Good God from Zion, look here. God has given him instruction on what to do. But the problem we have, we don't want to follow instructions. And I give a witness here. If God tell us to go to the Dollar Tree and buy a loaf of bread, the first thing we'll tell, I'm not going to spend my dollar on no fellow man. You just miss your blessing. Can I get a witness here? Because when you give the bread to your fellow man, God got a blessing just waiting on you. Can I get a witness here? We got to learn to follow instruction. We got to have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying. Can I get a witness here?
That's right, that's right.
Oh, it troubles me how people sit home from Sunday eve to Sunday morning. Lord, don't help nobody. Don't care about nobody. But you can stay on the internet. You can tweet all night long. But yet you love God. I'm gonna get all into your face today. Can I get a witness now? But you don't have your turning for God. Can I get a witness now? Then you can come here and shout the pews back. It won't help nobody. Can I get a witness here? The Bible said, even in the Sunday school, he that don't show love don't know God. If you don't know God, you're going to die in hell. Can I get a witness here? But look here. Oh, God told you, why get your pen right? Because you got to do some right. Now I want you to go and start writing to the church. But one thing that got in my heart, I want each one of them to do some soul searching. Lord, have mercy. Because we are the church. And then see what we are doing for St. Jude. Can I get a witness here? The God from Zion. The Lord told me to take, because you're in the choir stand, because you're on the pulpit, because you're on the deacon ministry, because you're on the trustee, you might be the treasurer, financial secretary, or whatever auxiliary you hold. That don't mean nothing to him, because he's looking for somebody with clean hands and a pure heart. That's going to lift him up, that's going to help his children, that's going to tell the wrong, that they're wrong, that's going to tell the right, that you're right. Yes, God told me to take, your voice don't mean nothing if your heart not right.
Yes, sir.
Some people have got to the point you think you're New York steak with potatoes and greens on the side. But I stopped by to tell you, you never burn a bottle on the water. Get ready to be burned.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But look at him. Look at him. Lord, have mercy. But you know one thing it is? Read in the Bible that God got zero tolerance for sin. Zero tolerance for sin. Because when I mistreat him, God don't like it.
Read your Bible. Yeah, Lord.
got to get it right. We got to get it right. Look at that Terry. He told them, he said, but I have this complaint against you. You are permitting women that are Jezebel, who call herself a prophet, to lead my servant astray. The God Almighty. She teaches them to commit sexual sin, to eat offering, to idols. I'm trying to show you something. Church, we got to get right. Now, some things here don't relate to sex too, but some things do. Can I get a witness here? We done come from a long way, but we got a long way to go. Can I get a witness here? It's not about us, but it's all about him. Can I get a witness here? I understand. Sometimes your money gets short, but there's always work to do around here. You can call and say, can I help with this? Tell God, you know my finance is not right. But whatever you want me to do, send me. I'll do it. Can I get a witness here? And when you tell him, and you have made up your mind, God said, I will supply all of your needs according to my riches. Can I get a witness here? Oh, my God. But look in here. I'm getting ready to come. He talking to Cyrus now. He said, I know all things you do, that you have a reputation for being alive, but really you're dead. He's talking to the one that giving him that false praise. Can I get a witness here? Because when you give God a real praise, preach it, man, it'll run from heart to heart. It'll run from breath to breath. Yes, when he gets happy and the Holy Ghost got it, it'll hit me, hit Evan. But when you sit there like a knot on the log, nothing happened. You better check yourself out. Can I get a witness here? Because if you got a little fire, the fire should catch up. Can I get a witness here? Yes! If you stay around fire, you're going to catch on fire. Can I get a witness here? But look at the church of Philadelphia. We're doing most of everything all right. Lord, have mercy. He said, no, you're not hard or cold. Lord, have mercy. He said, but let me tell you something. The church that is lukewarm, you make me sick. You make me sick. Can I get a witness here? Yeah, Lord. I'm sorry, that was Laodicea. But the Philadelphia, this is the message from the one who's the whole truth, the one who has to kill David. What he opens, no man can close. And what he closes, we want to be like Philadelphia.
That's right.
Those doors that go hinder us from blessing God, we want to close those doors. We want him to close them. We don't want to close them. See, because when we close them, Christian, you know what happens? We take the door lock off. So we can go back through. So when times get hard, you can go back through. But my brother, but when God closed the door, you can call the door of the man. And he can't even open the door. Can I get a witness here?
That's right, that's right.
Y'all see somebody shooting, we come out. See, that's a trick.
That's right.
How many of you study your word and the Bible fall out your hand? Yeah. It's because he don't want you to study. Yeah. You can't study when you're tired. But I thank God for John. John, the rebel. thank God for John being a fellow, so God can use him. I thank God because it put me in the mind of Daniel. Because Daniel, he was a praying man. Can I get a witness here?